It is typically very distressing news for patients to hear that they have pancreatic cancer. Although from the surgical point of view, if we can do the operation to remove the tumor, then we do give the patient some chance of hope for having long-term survival, more than 5 years, for example, even. So that is possible. So we do have patients who are alive 5, 6, 10 years after diagnosis of pancreatic cancer, only because they were able to have the operation. So it's important to discuss with your doctor, you know, what your treatment options are. Unfortunately, once it has spread, it typically implies only chemotherapy. Unfortunately, the problem is that the majority of patients, when they're diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, already have tumors spread to other organs, which then precludes them from having any sort of surgery, and they go on to receive chemotherapy. And as such, then the prognosis is typically not very good. The only treatment option that can result in any long-term survivorship is, when detected early, is surgery. And surgery can only be performed, or is only worthwhile being performed, when the tumor has been confined to the pancreas. And that, unfortunately, does not happen too often. But when it does happen, then for most patients, that's a very good option. The surgery, though, can be complicated, either with a Whipple operation or removal of part of the pancreas. We know that the greatest risk factor so far that we know about pancreatic cancer is smoking, and so that it is something that people can do to quit, and that would definitely decrease the risk of getting pancreatic cancer. We also know that obesity is also a very important factor, as are genetics. Sometimes you can do something about smoking and something about obesity. Genetics is very difficult to do anything about. But other than that, we still don't know much more regarding the cause of pancreatic cancer. So there are certain lifestyle changes that people can do. One, of course, is stop smoking, exercise, and eat healthy. Those things will go a long way, not just for pancreatic cancer, but for our overall well-being in general. There's been a recent estimate that pancreatic cancer will be increasing greatly in the future, partly because of the aging population, but also because of the difficulty of obesity in the United States. So we will probably expect to see an increase in the number of pancreatic cancers over the next 10 to 20 years. There are currently several things going under investigation. The problem is that pancreatic cancer, in general, though, typically strikes so few people, that screening the whole population does not become very productive. So there are centers that have undergoing screening for people who have multiple family members with pancreatic cancer. Then there is some worthwhile endeavor in screening, although, to be honest, that's still under investigation, and we don't know exactly how long. Here at the Med Center, though, we are undergoing multiple areas of research in regards to screening and early detection of pancreatic cancer, for which we have several research endeavors, one of which we believe will be coming soon to help screen people with diabetes who may then develop pancreatic cancer. Due to the unique characteristics of the medical center's practice in pancreatic cancer, as well as the bench science or basic science component done at UNMC as well as at Epley, we have one of the few very coveted prestigious grants from the National Cancer Institute in Washington, D.C. to study pancreatic cancer. So it's one of a handful given to centers around the country, and we're fortunate to have one of those. So we have a deep committed interest in pancreatic cancer in all aspects that's been funded by the government. There's always ongoing research, and there's been some very important breakthroughs recently with regards to pancreatic cancer that will hopefully translate into some meaningful treatments in the next several years. So I think there's still more to do, but there's some early signs of some productive research that's been going on. So we will make strides in treating pancreatic cancer.